Hi everybody, I'm Lights, Camera, Jackson. She sung ABBA, Sondheim, and Springsteen. Now three-time Oscar winner Meryl Streep tackles opera as Florence Foster Jenkins. In the history books, Jenkins is defined as the world's worst singer. But even though that was a headline used to sell papers in the 40s, and a slogan that will be used to sell tickets to this movie, Streep and director Stephen Frears proved that Jenkins was much more than that. Or at least they try to. Jenkins' real-life story was not a comedy, and yet Florence Foster Jenkins attempts to be one, with Streep giving her most campy performance of the past decade. Set in 1944 in New York City, it begins with Florence and her husband, St. Clair Bayfield, played by Hugh Grant, performing theatrical skits at the Verdi Club, which Florence founded a quarter century earlier. At the end of the night, she tells the audience that music has always been, and is, my life. But Florence thinks it's time to return to singing on the stage. They soon look for a new piano accompanist for Florence's daily vocal exercises with one of the city's top coaches, and find their talented young man in Cosme McMoon, Simon Helberg from The Big Bang Theory. The first time you hear Streep sing, the extremely high-pitched tone may make you laugh a bit in shock. Frears spends the next 10 to 15 minutes solely on Florence's singing lessons. The audience at the screening I attended couldn't stop laughing out loud as she kept belting out out-of-tune notes. But here's the thing, Florence believes she has a wonderful voice. To continue to laugh at her throughout these scenes, instead of trying to understand her delusion, completely misses the point. It was a mistake for Frears to steer audiences to think like that, depicting this woman and her life the wrong way. This film is more of a tragedy, which becomes clearer as we learn bits and pieces of Florence's past. The first hour is largely devoted to setup and subplots primarily involving St. Clair. Grant may actually have more screen time than Streep. As for Miss Merrill, outside of the singing, which is impressive, Streep does it all, mimicking Florence's vocals perfectly, it's not as immersive, showy, or fearless as some of her recent work. But she does captivate during a few quiet scenes, including a well-handled climax. Though interesting to watch and discussion-worthy, with an off-key script and an unfocused direction, Florence fails to hit the high notes. On the official LCJ report card, Florence Foster Jenkins gets a C+. I'm Lights, Camera, Jackson. For all the latest news and movie reviews, go to lights-camera-jackson.com, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and follow me on Twitter at LCJ Reviews.